Scripture reading this morning is taken from John, the Gospel of John, chapter 10, verses 11 to 18. This can be found on page 103 in the New Testament portion of your Pew Bible. So reading from John chapter 10, beginning at verse 11. Hear what the Spirit says to the church. I am the good shepherd. The good shepherd lays down his life for the sheep. The hired hand, who is not the shepherd and does not own the sheep, sees the wolf coming and leaves the sheep and runs away. And the wolf snatches them and scatters them. The hired hand runs away because a hired hand does not care for the sheep. I am the good shepherd. I know my own, and my own know me, just as the Father knows me and I know the Father. And I lay down my life for the sheep. I have other sheep that do not belong to this fold. I must bring them also, and they will listen to my voice. So there will be one flock, one shepherd. For this reason the Father loves me, because I lay down my life in order to take it up again. No one takes it from me, but I lay it down of my own accord. I have power to lay it down, and I have power to take it up again. I have received this command from my Father. This is the word of the Lord.
So when you came to church this morning, were you expecting to sing Joy to the World? Some of you are a little bit shocked, thought that, oh no, Fiona's crazy. Or maybe you blamed it on Cody, those musicians will do anything. But I thought, why not? Why not celebrate Jesus our Lord at his resurrection with a song about his birth? Because if you look at the words of Joy to the World, it actually sounds more like an ascension or reign of Christ unto him than a Christmas one. There's phrases in it like, let earth receive her king, the Savior reigns, no more let sin and sorrow grow, he rules the world. These kind of sound more like triumphant kingly songs than about songs about a baby born in a lonely stable. And yet we as Christians sing it at Christmas once or twice and then leave it alone for 365 days. But is that a way to go? Gail asked me last week if I wanted the Easter decorations down. And I said, no, leave them up for another Sunday. For we are Easter people. We are people that say, Alleluia, Christ is risen. Christ is risen indeed. And it is because we are Easter people that we are able to sing Joy to the World at Christmas and all through the year. And as we sing Joy to the World and songs like Because He Lives or Lord of the Dance, even the offertory, we sing with joy and enthusiasm because we know Christ. For Christians, Joy to the World, the Lord has come, is more than just a baby in a manger. Because we know what happens. We can sing loudly because we know the story. We know how it ends. We've read the ending. We know about the angels telling Mary she would bear a son. We know about Joseph, that he was to name him Almighty God, Prince of Peace. We know about the shepherds and the angels in the highest heaven. We know about tidings of great joy, of the birth of a king. And so we, like them, we sing. We sing about the joy of his birth. And we are brought to tears. Not so much because of the story of his birth or even his life, but because we know the ending. We see the cross in the manger, and we know that it is for us. And we smile knowing that the cross is empty and that so is the tomb, that the baby is swaddled in cloths no more, for the cloths now lay inside an empty tomb. But what if you didn't know? What if you didn't know the middle or the ending? What do the words of the song mean without knowledge of who they are sung about? Are they just empty words if you don't know their meaning? What if you didn't hear about Jesus' teaching about God's love, about what the kingdom of God is like? What if you hadn't heard about the Good Samaritan or the widow's mite? What if you didn't know Jesus as the Good Shepherd who laid down his life for his sheep? What if you didn't know that this baby would perform miracles, teach teachers, turn the temple and the world upside down with his message? What if you didn't know that that baby was the message? For God so loved the world, he gave his only begotten Son, that all who believe in him may have eternal life. I can't imagine not knowing. Can you? I can't imagine only seeing the baby and not the man. I've only seen the manger and not the cross and the crown. I've only seen the stable and not the empty tomb. And yet so many hear a hymn like Joy to the World, but don't know the message. The Christmas story is largely non-threatening to non-believers. Jesus in the manger, surrounded by Mary and Joseph and the adoring shepherds, is easy to share and easy to hear. We love to celebrate a birth. At Christmas, we prepare, we plan, we decorate, we have special services. We invite friends over, we celebrate, we buy presents, send cards, or even more generous and loving. How much special stuff did you do for Easter? The world seems lighter and friendlier at Christmas. Even for a non-believer, it's not hard to hear the recounting of the birth of a great teacher. Anyone can enjoy that. But then we have the Easter story. It's both appalling and astonishing. The betrayal of Jesus by one of his closest followers. The triple denial by his best friend. The gruesome crucifixion. And the brutal end to his earthly life. How do you share that with a non-believer? How do you explain that Jesus had to die, that it was part of God's plan? How do you explain that Jesus' sacrifice brought us closer to God? That he bridged the gap between earth and heaven? At Christmas, we can laugh. We can share the story over a piece of Christmas cake. But what kind of cake goes with crucify him? Crucify him. What kind of party do we have at the foot of the cross? And then there's that stunning turn of events 3 days later. An empty tomb, thieves, a gardener. No, wait. It's Jesus. Risen, appearing to Mary, to the disciples. Christ is risen, risen indeed. But not with exclamation points, with question marks. Christ is risen? Mary didn't know what was going on. The disciples didn't know what was going on, but they shared what they saw. Unsure if they would be ridiculed or mocked by friends, Mary and the others in their grief, not really knowing what was going to happen next, shared their experience so others would know, feel what they were feeling. And for us today, sitting here in these pews, we are here because they shared, because the shepherds shared. Maybe you're here because your parents shared, or a friend. Maybe it was a teacher or a policeman, or even a stranger. But because others shared, we know what's next. We know the ending. And when I say we know the ending, I hope you don't just know the words, but rather the meaning. That you sit there knowing what it means to call Christ your shepherd, not just with your brain, but with your heart and your soul. that you have experienced the power of knowing that Jesus' words, "My sheep know my name and I lay my life down for them," that these words are not empty, but full of promise, of truth, of action. It is not just words that Jesus speaks. He did it. He didn't have to. He said, "I choose to lay down my life." But we're not the ones who need to hear it, are we? We rather are the ones who need to share it. Easter means that nothing is impossible with God, that life triumphs over death, love triumphs over hatred, hope triumphs over despair, and that suffering is not the last word. Who here thinks that's a message to share? The shepherds spoke from a place of uncertainty and joy. They shared an easy message of the birth of a king. Mary, Thomas, Peter shared a harder message from a place of uncertainty and grief. From where do we share our message of Christ? I have to admit, I'm afraid. I'm worried about being ridiculed and rejected for sharing my faith story, even with family and friends. But I know that if I truly believe the words that I sing, if I truly know their meaning, if I know the stories, if I feel in my heart the joy of knowing my Savior, if I know my Lord lives, and if I dance with him, then I need to not fear. As a church, as a congregation, looking to grow in faith and in numbers, looking to go and to meet the people south of Fish Creek to bring the word of God. As a church, there is no place for fear or human discomfort. Christmas story, Easter story, and everything in between. God has given us the words. He has altered our lives with their meaning. And I believe God gave to us the living word in his son Jesus, and that the only way, the only wrong way to share the message of Christ is to not share it. Any other way, as long as you're sharing it, is the right way. The message is in our hearts. God's words are on our tongues. We say, we sing, "Joy to the world. The Savior reigns." And we are called to share, to repeat Christ's story with joy. Repeat Christ's story with joy. Repeat, repeat Christ's story with joy. Amen and amen. So let us join in singing "Because He Lives."